Hey, what's up, everyone? It's Tamimi from Solace. If you missed out on our first episode of the Solace Community Lightning Talks, don't worry about it. I've got you covered. The fourth talk featured Heiko, who talked about using Prometheus and Grafana with Solace, followed by a demo. Check it out, and don't forget to leave your comments and discussions on our community thread on solace.community.
Hello and welcome to a short introduction of how to monitor Solace Broker using Prometheus open source monitoring. Here a little architecture overview. We are using Prometheus. Prometheus scrapes and Solace exporter, it's in Go language written exporter, using HTTPS. Solace exporter using again HTTPS with XAMPP V1 to access either on-prem broker or cloud broker. We are here focusing currently on XAMPP V1 because XAMPP V2 isn't feature complete for on-prem broker. As you can see here, we are having a virtual machine running Docker. Here you can see our Solace Enterprise and our Solace Exporter. Solace Exporter is the Go written tool you're also able to find on GitHub, DuckBeak, Solace Exporter, and as completely compiled Docker container as Docker Hub. Okay, now let's have a deeper dive into the Solace Exporter and what it provides. Here you can see our Solace Exporter running on port 9628. And all endpoints. You can see here the exporter internal metrics, but these are not very interesting. Interesting part is Solace Broker and Solace VPN. We split those metrics into parts because if we like to monitor Solace Cloud instances, we only have access to the Solace VPN part, not to the broker part. And again, here we split the VPN part into three levels. Standard, statistic, and details metric. If you look at the standard metrics, you can see here the config sync state, the local status of all my VPNs, the spool byte. See here how much space is used of all my VPNs, and a lot of further information. Now, why we split everything into three parts? That is because Prometheus normally polls the broker and polls the exporter. That means Prometheus will ask periodically what the current status is. And those three parts here provide different types of metrics, meaning collecting standard metrics is no problem for the broker. It can be served very fast. The statistic metrics takes a little longer. So shouldn't be scraped in this high interval as the standard. And again, the details takes a little more time. So if you want have to look into metrics, detail metrics, you will see. If we now look into the detail metrics, you can see here, we are listing here all queues. You only should do that if you don't have so much queues. If you have thousands of queues on your broker, scraping the detail endpoint will blow up your Prometheus and your broker performance. So don't do it if you expect a lot of queues. But in our case, you can see here all our queues and how much spool those queues are using. Now we have seen a Solace exporter and Prometheus is scraping those. But let's jump over Prometheus and let's look at Grafana. Grafana is a metric visualization tool like this. What we can see here is a dashboard for our Solace broker. We are currently at the VPN level. You can see here my broker and my VPN and see VPN status, my config sync status of those VPNs, how much clients are connected, my transfer message volume, and how my broker looks like. I have no client discard messages in and out. I have no slope screwdriver. Everything looks good. But here in our queue level, I see I have a lot of queues without any consumer. This might be a problem. So I should analyze my application. Below here, I see my queue usage. None of my queues are full. The message VPN spool is not full, and here I see the number of messages I currently have spooled over time. We also have a broker overview. Currently here I see complete broker. This is interesting for on-prem broker. I see my mate statistic, I see my compute latency, my connection counts, my redundancy state, lot of transfer volumes. Everything in a graphical view. You can simply edit it, those views, but this is the view we are providing with the Solace exporter that can easily be used from you. We have also created dashboards for bridges. Here you can see all bridges of my broker and status history of those bridges. Here you can see something has changed. Someone edited my bridge, so there is not longer a queue available. So now let's go back to Prometheus. We have seen all those visualizations, but what we really want to know is when an accident happened, we want to get to be notified. So let's look at Prometheus. Here we can see our rule set. So the rule sets can be created by you. We'll now see our sample rule sets. As you can see here, for example, we monitoring the broker hardware spool. If the broker hardware spool is above a level of 80% for 1 hour, I get a notification on my smartphone. As well as the message limit is over the queue, over the quota, or the connection limit goes very up. You can define here a lot of other and different rules. It's completely up to you. And you have a lot of notification mechanisms using Prometheus. More to that you will find at the Prometheus documentation. If you have a short look at the Solace exporter documentation, you can see here our different endpoints and where they are for. And a little bit below, you see the configuration. In the case I showed already here, where we have the exporter and the broker on the same virtual machine, we use the classic configuration style. In this case here, you can use a configuration file or either a more Docker-like. You can use your environment variables. In this case, you will see a very unsecure broker, but it's just for demonstration, don't panic. You will see here we are scraping our local IP with the standard XAMPP port and username password given, all standard. Now we also use Solace exporter for Solace Cloud. You can see here my test broker Bridge 11, and also you can see my monitoring stats for Bridge 11. This broker is nearly new one and have no clients and nothing connected to. You can see here just one simple queue with a bridge, just for our automatization tests. So what you see now here is the exporter URL, and you see it's not the expected URL. From the documentation, it's not Solace standard or Solace detail or whatever, completely different URL. Let me show you why. What we have done here is we don't like to put any credentials to the Solace Cloud Broker because we have the exporter just once for all our Cloud Broker, centralized. And putting the username and password into Prometheus is a possible option, would still work, but it's not recommended because Prometheus is really talky, and in our case it's public readable. So we introduced an Nginx reverse proxy, keeping those passwords and usernames. So what we do now, Prometheus is scraping the Nginx reverse proxy using HTTPS GET. The Nginx reverse proxy is converting those HTTPS GET to an HTTPS POST. It's containing the broker credentials like URL, username, and password for the MP1 at HTTP body. So it's completely secure, it will never show on any logs, and we don't need to configure all brokers in the Solace exporter. We can keep it stateless and easy to update. We only have our Nginx reverse proxy keeping all those credentials secure, binded to our self-service portal. Here is the matching documentation for this example. What the Nginx proxy does is calling Solace VPN standard and putting this grape URL username and password into URL. This is possible, like seen here, using HTTPS GET or HTTPS POST. This GET parameters may be shown up somewhere in log files or as firewall logs, so just to be secure, using POST. That's now my presentation of the Solace exporter. Hope you enjoyed, and if you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask.